If you hear the fire bell, please don't panic or yell. Your safety, we assure, if you exit via the fire door. Now, in the hall there are three. Turn your heads and you'll see that there are two at the rear. But if you're in the front, there's one here. Now, I know it's a drag, but you can't have a fan. No, not even a puff. You see, the cast makes enough. They've got a new way of smoking, and I really am not joking. So, but in the interval, you can dash outside to crash the ash. Oh yes, in the middle there will be a break for a tea and cake. Well, it's a biscuit, but cake is the line. Now there are ices and lollies and trips to the loo and a raffle if we've still got the time. Now, what could be worse than a cast well rehearsed and an audience that don't know its cue? So, remember tonight, you will get things right. Whether you hiss, or you cheer, or you boo. Well, now I will hand you back to Brian and Ron. I've done my bit. I must be gone.
It sounds very noisy, so shout it loud. anybody?
I don't think so.
Well, what about us?
Of course, the most important lot of all.
I'm Sing.
I'm Song.
I'm Ding.
I'm Dong.
I'm Ying.
I'm Yang.
I'm Ching.
I'm Chen.
I'm Bing.
I'm Fong.
I'm Wing.
I'm Wong.
I'm Ping.
I'm Fong.
I'm Kong.
I'm Fu.
I'm Han.
I'm Song.
Short. Rick Short. License.
sense to swill. My friends call me Big Rick. That's what they call me anyway. Sounds like. Well, the lad and his mum had a dream, and now it's disappeared in steam. All is doom and gloom. Aww. And strife. Aww. No thriving business. Aww. Very competitive, aren't you? No pretty wife. Aww. Since they've lost the laundry contracts, their hopes have dashed. Now that's a fact. And when I go, say bye, Ricky. You remember that? When I come on, I should have said this earlier, I've got to say, very embarrassing. When I come on, say, hi, Ricky!
Hi, Ricky!
Pretend you did that when I first came on, and now I'm going, and you say,
hi, Ricky!
Thank you.
It's true, we're on our uppers. And soon we'll have to sing for our suppers. This old laundry has had its day. The tub is cracked. There's debts to pay. It puts me in a real mean mood. Oh, pardon me. How could I have been so rude? Let me introduce myself. I'm Widow Twanky. You guessed it here. Well, let's have a look at your nice big crowd in tonight, yes? Could we get a hair appointment, dear? Never mind, it's dark in here most of the evening. Oh, you've got nice dresses over here. Same as last year, yes? Well, I can't stand around here all day wasting time. I must look for my like lad of mine. Oh, laddie! Oh, there you are, my lad.
Mother, how did things get so bad?
Running a business these days, it's hard to make things go. My overheads are very high and my profits very low.
But where has all the money gone? What on earth have you spent it on?
Well, there's the water costs, and there's the heating costs, and there's the soap powder costs.
Have you any hidden assets, Mother dear?
Don't mean that, my boy. I should think that's quite clear.
No. I mean like a Swiss bank account. Large or small? Any amount?
Now I know he's off his rocker. That boy of mine's in for a shocker. Not a penny, not a bean, not a sou, nor a yen. Unless there's a miracle, it's the bailiff's men.
Thank you.
What's that?
Since I lost the laundry contract to the governor of Honky Tonky, all my plans now have gone wonky, wonky, wonky.
Do you know what they are?
No.
Thank goodness for that.
Last Sunday we had a contingent of school children. I said, do you know what the three rules are? And 200 hands shot up. And I thought, oh heck, now what do I do? I said, okay, tell me what they are, little boy said, if the fire alarm bell goes. Three rules are, if you see a baddie, you... If you see a goodie, you...
Yay!
And if you see me, you... There's always one in every audience, isn't there? I've got this letter slipped underneath the door just now, and it says, Dear sir, I see you're on stage again. Yo-yo. Why, oh, why? The old one. Well, selling soap is pretty chum. It really is a life that's rough. Even though I'm at the top of my profession, there is one small confession. Some of my customers are not too clean, if you know what I mean. Encouragement is what they require. So if I aspire more dazzle powder to sell this day, three samples I must give away. A person with a slight aroma could be my biggest, wait for it, customer.
Oh dear. But these running costs are getting out of breath. I really think they should be banned. They make me get all hot and sticky. And keeping clean can be quite tricky. What I need is a good luck fairy to keep me nice and fresh and airy.
It's not a fairy that you require, come here. Nor to a moo should you aspire, but a powder that won't make you frazzle. The wonder washing powder. The wonder washing powder. It happens at rehearsals, doesn't it? Dazzle!
For a moment I thought I was going to get a flash. I was getting ready to make a dash. You know I cannot afford such a luxury to launder my dainty lingerie.
Madam, it is your lucky day that I should come along this way. Pray, listen to my heartfelt plea and let me give you powder. Free. When you have given it a try, loads more packs you're bound to buy.
What can I lose? I'll take the lot. To try to see if I have got a chance to make my laundry boom. At last a rate to write my glue.
May I make a small suggestion to help you end your large recession? A washing powder demonstration could reinstate your occupation.
Cheer me up, you cheeky man. So let us see if now you can. Cheer up this audience as well. Not that I think that they smell.
Now, we've got a little bit of a problem with this song, because it involves whistling. What we've discovered in the last 3 months is neither of us can whistle. Right. So we'd like you to give us a hand. Now, it's a song you all know. We want you to join in, but particularly join in with the whistling, because we can't do it. But you ready? Some things in life are sad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, so grumble, give a whistle. And this will make things turn out for the best.
And that's the luck and chance and all and
things. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps.
Just play your lips and whistle, that's the thing.
Always look on the bright side of life.
and widow bound. Forget about your sin, give the audience a grin. You'll see it's all the show. Keep on laughing as you go. Remember that the last one is on you. Get some washing. I'm doing my best to get some more doshing. But everyone's broke, their possessions in hock. Look, Andy Summerfield only gave me one sock. But mustn't get gloomy, that'll never do. I'll ask this lot if they will share talk to me. What about you, ducks? Are you my dear? Get your washing clean and bright. It'll get the dicky dirt out of your shirt and bring your smalls up white. I can understand your hesitation. What you require is a little demonstration. Wake up, you two. I need help with the dinner. It's time to earn your keep. Have you noticed? Non-stop chatter, these two. Can't get a word in edgeways. Come on, get on with it.
Here, Arthur. We get it cream.
Pretty disgusting, hey? We're gone now. Well, it's been.
Get on, get on!
We go twanky, she unfurled the car of our woman, and yours gathered blood.
Thank you. Have to wash up for ever.
Finally, how to make a mess of things. So far, they don't need me, but things all go from bad to worse. Just you wait and see!
I don't know what's going on. No, don't.
Yes, I do. Well, he means to overlook my words for a lad and his mother. But before the pantomime is through, they'll sort out one another. But in case I need to make a deal and sell my washing powder to Ebenezer, suppose I better keep on the right side of him, even though he's a...
Mean
a mean old geezer.
Try again. Mean old geezer.
See you all later.
Bye. Bye.
Julian Clary, make your choice.
I'm the only
Twinkie, we're in a full trouble. We need brand new everything.
I'll do it on the double. Okay, I'm just warming up a little.
Hang on a minute, hang on a minute. I'll get these brilliant bit of smoke and a nice spotlight, drums and everything. And I'll come down here and I'll get one spotlight. I think I deserve two, don't you?
Yeah!
I didn't hear you. I deserve two, don't I?
Yeah!
No, it's not working. No, try again. Yeah! Brilliant! Thank you very much. I'll tell you, they want a brand new everything. Oh, what a fuss. But it's okay because I am a genius. What do you think we should have in our laundry? I could do with a bit of advice. Can anybody tell me what would be nice?
Oh, come on!
A washing machine, a hot point automatic. I think that would be really, really magic. Anything else?
Tumble dryer.
Brilliant, yeah. And I reckon we should also have an electric fryer. Anything else, you reckon?
Iron.
A bar of soap. Now I can stick with the washing
counter.
An iron, yes. Walking pictures I hear are quite good. I've also heard that Weatherhead's have got a sale on as well. 20% off. So boy, you'll pop up there pretty quickly. I know as well. I reckon if we had a nice big flashing neon sign in the background, don't you think that'd be really, really good? Yes, I think it would. Oh well, I say enough of this hanky panky. I'm going to go and speak to Widow Twanky. For you, I've got a big surprise. You're not going to believe your eyes.
I can't wait to see what we have got when the lights come on. Voila!
Voila!
It's wonderful!
Well, it was nothing. I tried my best, but I'll easier for a little rest. If I need it, then rock the lamp, master. Next time I'll try and be a little faster.
Thank you.
believe me eyes. Washing, tumbling, ironing, powder everywhere. If business stays as brisk as this, well, you'll soon be a millionaire.
You were right as ever, Uncle. My bank account is wealthy. Rich is now beyond my dreams. I've never been so wealthy.
Congratulations, nephew. Your future's looking bright, but tell me, how did you manage to get all this work done overnight? Was overtime the answer? Was the night shift locking on? Widow Twanking wasn't helping. Oh, I like the flashing neon.
Should I tell my Uncle Ebenezer? No. I'm sure I can trust him. He is my uncle. No. I will tell him. No. Secret very simple.
Oh, you are a teaser. All hard work and no play is what makes us a success. I'm just like the TSB, I always like to say yes. Wishy, get the idea. Washy, start the scrubbing. Look alive, the pair of you. Don't just stand there blubbing. Shame you had to go, dear. I'm so sorry you must go. Pity you have to go so soon. It really is a and he's not a man to trust.
Archie now, our hands have all gone red. Hello, Cordelia.
So we can go to bed.
I rub my magic hand and rub. I rub it till it's sheeny. I rub it then just one more time. And poof, out comes the teeth.
I am your slave and master, and I live in yonder vault. With noise that rhyme as bad as that, the scriptwriter should be shot.
My little genial genie with the light brown hair. You can start by getting the washing done. Is that pile over there?
It's homeward bound, and to bed we go, and a lion in the morning.
I can't watch that Jimmy work so hard.
Well, I've already started yawning.
I'll take it home with me right now and leave this place in a mess.
Stop! None shall own this lantern, for it means that it's not fair. So if any man should steal my lamp, he'll disappear who knows where.
A problem. I don't want to disappear. Goodness knows where I would go. It could be Bedfordshire.
Another
go. There's always one, isn't there? And I think it's mine. There must be a way to get that lump. Aladdin will have his price. If I could trick him in some way, wouldn't that be nice? Oh yes, it was!
Oh,
yes, it was!
What a relief! I had a dream last night. The lamp was stolen out of sight. By my wicked uncle Ebenezer. He must be an evil man, a real mean geezer. I found him in the governor knitting pattern of honky-tonky on the flying carpet, not on a donkey. I'm feeling our business now that we are success. Though, I know, shouldn't really ought to see Willow Patton, his beautiful daughter. If I can bring her to my side, I will make her my beautiful bride.
I doubt Willow Patton would be your ideal mate. She's had life handed to her on a plate. But now that we are wealthy, you may find, she and her father may change their mind.
My command, young master, but in case you meet with disaster, this magic ring I will give you. Though not as powerful as it'll have to do.
And now, before I dare to venture on my next great adventure, come all my friends and join with me in a party! Huzzah!
And it's all free!
Free!
Ha ha ha! sexy looking peasant.
What's this?
For me?
A present.
Yes, well, I wonder what could come in a packet this size, don't I?
It's chocolate, isn't it?
No.
Cigars.
Oh, well, we'll see, shall we? The laddie, chief executive, Cranky's laundry limited.
A token only, Governor. You know you are my hero. The laundry's up for sale. You must be very cautious here. And can I marry Willow?
What? No, you may not.
Look at the laundry. That I know about. It's doing well, no doubt.
I know my daughter thinks me vain, but I'd like to add it to my chain of laundries in faraway places. We can make it special, a real showcase.
Father, why not go and see this laundry? You could do it at your leisure. You've had no holiday for a long, long time. This could be business as well as pleasure.
Daughter, there is merit in what you say.
Then may I suggest we leave today?
No, you may not. The decision is mine. The day, the date, the time.
Without being discourteous, I have to say there is no time for delay. Other buyers I have in mind. Then you, I'm afraid, will be left behind.
In that case, I have no choice. Servants, hear my voice. Pack the chests and cases with clothes and gold. Hurry now, do as you're told. Dismiss these visitors. They can dine when we are free another time.
day, we never took her. We never had a chance to book her. Mom and Jeannie were away, so now we're very bored, aren't they? Don't get us wrong, we're not ungrateful. We only want to feel we're useful. We need to find another way to help us through each passing day. We could have fun with our new folk. Ah, shall we tell them all our joke? Ah, you tell your joke.
Okay.
What's your call? A lovely in Peking. I don't know what you call a lovely in Peking. A Chinese takeaway. Chinese lady who has food mixer on her head. I don't know what you call a Chinese lady with food mixer on her head.
I call her blender.
Thank you.
Well,
you've got it flaunted, that's what I say. And I can tell you, I've got a bit more to floor than most of you. What about you, chaps? I know what you're thinking.
Yes, sir.
Oh,
yeah, you don't get many of those in a pound, do you?
The more I get, the more I need. It isn't only nasty greed, but I never want to be so low as once again to have no dough.
Cherry lamp down. I'll see you all right. You leave the lamps alone. You lamps for all. Tonight you and night.
Did I hear you right, old man? It sounds too good to be true. For my old one, you'll give a lamp that's shiny and new.
That's right, pretty maid. That's what I say.
Oh, he certainly has a way with words, doesn't he? Come this way into the shop. I have an old lamp that's not needed anymore. See if that will do.
Ha! A tricky old girl!
I will exchange for one that's shiny and new.
Prefer this one over here. I'll take it if I might.
Please don't think I'm a scamp. I will not swap the genie in the lamp. No matter how you taunt and wail, this lamp is not for your caribou sale. You may bargain hard and long.
Rats! I need a diversion to get the lamp. Will you join me in a song?
A song? How charming. He's heard about my voice. What little ditty shall it be?
Oh, you have the choice.
I'll go and ask the orchestra. My, 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 we lashed out this year. Well, Mr. Charles, have you heard of a suggestion? Good suggestion, but I think we'll do the rehearsal song all right. That's a good name for a musician, Chimes, isn't it? What's the least the only music in the world? Neat and charming, in every high degree. I look so neat and nimble, though,
dashing away with a surly eye, dashing away with a surly eye, dashing away with a surly eye, Twanky's laundry.
I will give the lamp to this old man, I'm sure you will agree.
Can I help? I feel it is my duty. And may I say in passing, your daughter's a beauty.
Look, and who am I, Hubie?
This is my proposal. I am a very rich merchant, and my house is at your disposal. It wouldn't be hard for you and I, an agreement we could reach, and as part of it, you could include your daughter. What a peach!
How could you abandon Aladdin in an hour of need? I'm sure there is an explanation.
Nonsense, daughter. I'm sure with this merchant we can come to some arrangement. So to your house for rest and further talking.
I'll send for my victual. You must be tired of walking.
A washing powder man when things are really down the pan. The future's not looking too bright. At the end of this tunnel, there is no light. My biggest contract gone forever.
Aww.
No wonder I've been out of the weather. Now, do you think that's the cue for a song?
Yep.
Thank you, Ron. I've got to work out how to turn this thing on. Ron, power, power.
How about that? Wow!
Have a stop.
He's got it, Brian. He's really good. You know, I've seen a lot of professional guitar players that give their right arm to play like Brian. Give their right arm to play like Brian. Is that it? How about Ron? Ron here with his organ. Ron was in all the great groups in the 60s, weren't you, Ron? Who became famous after he left. There was Peter and Gordon and Ron. Dave D, Doty, Beaky, Mick, Titch and Ron. And most mysteriously of all, the Jackson Six. I'm ready now, you can start.
Thank you.
good girl. She's a pantomime. They were rubbish, weren't they?
No.
Oh, yes, they were. Anybody down there can do any better? Any children, perhaps? Anybody want to come up and show them how to march? For goodness sake, come on, I'm not going to do it all over again on my own. Listen, children. Hands up who wants to come up on stage. Come on, you children, let's have you up here. Can we have somebody from the back as well? Last Sunday we had 200 children up here. Nobody in the audience. Okay. Now I think we'll start from the second to last verse with the girls.
This man is old, hearted, quiet, a meaning, a nasty.
the old love button. Aladdin is young, kind and good looking. A real good looker.
Nonsense, daughter. He might be a little gruesome, but he is a little gruesome. But with use your imagination, I'm sure you'll make a handsome twosome.
Do not worry, she overcomes and I shall accept your offer.
I'm not overcome at all.
Thank you, my little brother.
My plan's working well.
Aren't I a lovable scamp?
Oh, yes, I am. I don't believe you. Though it's late, I'll have Widow Twankey here to show her that I mean to keep the lamp.
They've stopped him again, haven't they, Jane? Help!
I am the new master of the lamp. I got it in the end, you see. I'm number one. You will obey. Get with a Twankey here. Come on, don't delay.
You know I hate to do this. It's such a mean old thing. And where is young Aladdin? Has he forgotten about the ring? Oh, I know what, I'll send him a telepathic message to wherever he may be.
Come on, stop this foolery.
I'm free. Oh, sorry, I did that, didn't I?
Now here's a pretty mess I'm in. How I got here I'm not sure. Almost home, the ground gave way. I fell down to the floor. Willow and her father will be cross. They think they've been forsaken. I'm so tired, but I need an idea if I must save my bacon. I thought I heard a voice. What message did it bring? What was it? Let me think.
Aladdin, don't forget the ring.
I am a slave of the ring. What did you want me for? I wish to be transported to the house of my uncle Ebenezer. Do you know him?
Oh, everybody does. He's a real mean geezer.
So without further delay, I clap my hands. One, two, three, and you are on your way.
Thank you.
but that's as far as I can go. So, back into the lamp. See you later. Cheerio!
What am I doing here? Me just in my nighting. There's Governor Meeting and Willow Pattern. They'll think me rather flighty. There I was, just climbing into bed, when crash and bang and wallop, I find myself here instead. Do I look a trouble? Aladdin, you've turned up at last. We're in a spot of trouble. Old Meanie, he's got the lamp. The laundry's a pile of rubble. The money's gone, and the gold, and all my dresses too. All your friends are on the dole. What are we going to do?
I am the master. I will banish you all. And I be all. Far and wide, except for Willow Pattern. Who will stay here by my side? You thought I'd want your paltry money when I've got all that wealth. Stand over there with the other two. I want to see you count.
Thank you.
No sooner I saw it, it is done. Now to restore your riches and wealth.
Let's stop, kind genie. The things I want are happiness, friendship,
love,
and health.
Then, if this is so, return the lamp to me, and things will be as you wish. Back to the laundry that should be at Dentist. Everything else will vanish. Apart from friendship, happiness, love, and...
Although I don't wish to interfere, are you sure you're making the right decision, dear?
Mother, without a doubt, I feel so hale and hearty. Things will get better all the time. Let's all go home and have a party!
And then we will thrash 'em! Yeah.
Queenie the Slave of the Ring! Jones and Brian, they've done a great job. Yeah.
and Jill Sheffield, who's also been helping out with the stage management. Tickets and publicity, we've done well in terms of sell-out performances. I think the best we've ever done this year, and a lot of that is down to Eve McGrath, wherever she is. Probably the most important person from our point of view, our director, Rachel Waller, who's done everything really as far as we're concerned. Thank you, Rachel. Can you come up, please, Rachel? Rebecca doing this performance on her 14th birthday, which it is today.